In this tutorial, you will learn the weft interlocking method for weaving so that you can create patterns similar to this and join other yarns while you're weaving. You first have to decide how far in you want to go with one color. Then continue with plain weave to the point that you want to go to. Lead the tapestry needle out at that point and then begin weaving from the other side to the meeting point of the two yarns. So here will be like this extra or open space between the two, and this is where you're going to twist or cross the yarns. Here I like to do it in two steps, so here I'm just twisting one and then cross it back over so that the colors are back to its same side, or it will continue from the same side. And going in with the tapestry needle, continue and just make sure that there is now a link between the two. And this is the basis of the weft interlocking method. Instead of the two weft yarns interlocking between a warp yarn, they're just using each other to make this link or interlock. As you continue building other rows, be sure to secure the yarns with a fork or a loom comb. Now, beginning the next row, you're going to copy exactly what you did in the previous row. If you're going to continue it, continue the stopping point or the meet point to be at the same place, then continue exactly where you went before. This would vary if you're trying to make a diagonal pattern or a zigzag pattern with this, which is possible. But here we're just going to continue with the same exact meeting point. So again here, once they've both met at the same meeting point, I'm just going to twist them over each other just one time, pull through, and then I'm going to keep weaving and continuing the path. Now you can continue weaving using the interlocking method as long as you like. You can use this method for when you're adding colors or adding a different section. The weft interlocking method creates a different appearance than a warp interlocking method or weaving slits. It can create kind of this bubbling appearance here, like between these two yarn colors, which kind of creates this nice texture or interesting texture. It really depends on the yarn that you're using. Now, this also can be used to create a type of pattern. So let's say that you want to make it uneven or create this zigzag pattern. Thing that you have to do is change the point of meeting for the two different weft yarns. By changing the location, you can control where it will start and where it will end. Beginning a new row, weave color 1 and color 2 to the new start point. Once they're in place, twist the yarns around just like in the previous rows and continue weaving. If you want to continue weaving the two weft yarns at the same place, then you can continue that way. Or if you want to advance the color or the meeting point to another location, continue and repeat the previous instruction. Using alternative meeting points for the two different colors or three different colors can create a very interesting design and form something like a zigzag pattern like this, or you can also make it quite straight as well. Yeah, so I encourage you to just try different methods and experiment with the different colors and with different shapes or forms that you'd like to use. I hope that this tutorial has helped you learn more about the weft interlocking method. And if you have any questions, please leave them down below. And yeah, you can also find a written tutorial of this on my website. In addition to the warp interlocking and slit weaving, there will be future videos on these two other methods, and so please stay tuned. Thank you for watching. Bye!